Well, that's it, isn't it, really?
It?
12 months. 12 months out of my life for being an idiot, and then it'll all be over like a nightmare.
And that's the way we want it to be. We've always stood by you, your mum and I. We'll always be there, waiting. If you need us.
The prosecution will try to convince the jury that you are a cold-blooded and deliberate murderess. And when I get to your side of the story, your husband's attitude to the baby, his being in your bed with another woman while you were having that child aborted,
yes,
it will be rough. The question is, can you take him?
My husband was in the shower. I walked in and I stabbed him. Red. Oh, red.
Your Honor, I have no more questions. But I would ask that the court adjourn at this stage. Mrs. Travers is naturally upset.
That's reasonable, Mr. Wilson. Mr. Proudfoot, do you have any objections?
I have no objections, Your Honor.
All stand. This honourable court now stands adjourned until 3 o'clock. God save the Queen.
Very touching. The jury loved it. I wonder if they'll be as impressed when I've finished with her.
We are talking about deliberate murder, Mrs. Travers.
I know.
And you allege that you were driven to this crime by your husband's brutal behavior towards you.
Yes, sir.
Then let us examine the facts. Did you consult a doctor when your husband allegedly beat you?
No.
Did you tell anyone at all?
No.
Did anyone see you to be bruised or damaged in any way?
No.
When you applied to have your pregnancy terminated, what reason did you give the clinic?
I told them I didn't think I was emotionally ready to have children.
Not emotionally ready. I find myself inclined to believe that part of your statement, Mrs. Travers.
Your Honor.
Quite so, Mr. Wilson. Mr. Proudfoot, I don't think the court needs any more cheap jibes of that nature.
I put it to you, Mrs. Travers, that no one knew of your husband's alleged opposition to your pregnancy because there was, in fact, no such opposition. I put it to you, you elected to have an abortion for precisely the reasons you gave the clinic, and that having had it, guilty remorse drove you to blame your husband for your own failings and drove you ultimately and callously to murder him.
That isn't true. I wanted that baby more than anything else in the world. I wanted my child to live.
You wanted your child to live so much that when you terminated its life, you also murdered the man who fathered it because you could not face his judgment or your own guilt. There is not one shred of evidence presented to this court to support the allegation that your husband forced you to have an abortion or indeed ever mistreated you. The only indisputable fact before this court is that you killed him.
You know what we could organise? A bloody big petition. Get the same rights they've got in them Swedish prisons. The way I look at it, they've got everything laid on. Talk about the sweet life. That's not going to take your mind off tomorrow.
What?
Lying there worrying about it. not going to do you any good at all, my girl. You know, from what Kate tells me, her old man hasn't got a hope in hell of bringing up their daughter unless she's there. Bloody useless men are, if you ask me. Not worth a cracker. What do you reckon?
I wouldn't know.
No, not the type to play around, are you? Was he your one and only? I shopped around a bit before I settled on mine. Should have had more sense. Mind you, I was faithful to him after we were married. Just more than he was.
Oh, shut up, Bea.
Always on bloody time. What was he like?
Wayne?
Well, who else?
I used to think he was the most wonderful man in the world.
Yeah, me too.
It was after we got married that he changed completely. We never talked much. That's when he really started to drink. Killed him, Bea. I really killed him.
And now you think you're going to get away with it?
No, I don't think I'm going to get away with it.
What are you looking so cheerful about, as if I didn't know?
Yeah, isn't it great?
Some people have all the luck.
I wish you could all come.
Yeah. You had your chance when your brother dropped off.
Yeah, I wish I had some more relations to drop off.
Oh, here comes trouble. Good morning, Miss Bennett.
Come on, Warner, get a move on. You haven't got all day, you know. Miss Vernon wants to see you.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Hey, remember, kid, if you can't get the king size, don't bother.
And the big bottle of gin.
Yeah, giant economy size. And see if you can get some decent food, you know, like hamburgers and eggs.
Oh,
and
cut it out, you lot. Cheese. Come on, Warner.
Sorry.
You know what you'd get if you did try anything, don't you?
All the best, love.
Good luck. Good luck.
Coming.
I've got Warner outside to see you.
Oh, good. Bring her in, please.
In here, Warner.
Hello, Lynn. All ready for the big day?
Oh, I can't wait.
Well, I've no need to tell you that this is a big responsibility. If you abuse this privilege, you not only let yourself down, but me as well. Because I'll never be able to suggest this scheme again to the governor. And then all the other girls will miss out. So, it's up to you.
Oh, look, I won't let you down, I promise.
I know. But there are others who don't entirely agree with that. Now, I'll pick you up around about...
Oh, no, that'll be okay. I can make my own way back.
Well, I don't... Come in.
Sorry to interrupt, Jean. Thought I'd find you here. Now, as soon as you finish with Miss Vernon, I want you to nip down to the kitchen, pick up your lunch and get ready to sign out. That bus isn't going to wait, you know.
Can I?
Off you go, then. Good luck. And I will pick you up.
Well, I hope you know what you're doing. This might sound fine on paper at a university, but I think you've picked a bad guinea pig for your experiment.
Now, Lynn may have her faults, Vera, but I think we've got to give her the chance to prove herself.
She'll have a list of convictions in no time. What they probably didn't teach you is that most of these women don't want to be rehabilitated. You're wasting your time and putting the general public at risk.
I don't know. I'll never understand, Vera.
Oh, Lizzie.
On your way, are you?
Yeah, I'm just going.
Lynn, if you should find anything to drink, I mean anything at all while you're out, meths will do. Will you put a drop in this little bottle and bring it back to your old mate, will you, love?
Oh, Lizzie, I can't. They've put me on trust.
Oh, go on. You can do it easily. No one will know.
What are you two plotting? Birdsworth, get back to the laundry where you're supposed to be.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Changed your mind, have you, Warner? You'd rather stay here with your friends.
No, Miss Bennett.
Put one foot wrong today and it'll be the last time any girl gets out of here on one of these stupid schemes. Now get going.
Well, I still don't understand why you didn't mention the fact that your mother knew about the beatings.
It wouldn't have done any good. She'd never have backed me up. She prefers to pretend that these things don't happen in
nice families.
You realize, of course, that we could subpoena her. Now, once she's under oath...
No. I told her I'd never ask her for any help, and I won't go back on my word.
Well, you must know that you're tying my hands. Now, I thought that the whole point at the beginning was to bring out all the evidence that wasn't...
The Queen and Travers. The Queen and Travers.
What's this? Hey. Just don't be frightened. You tell the truth, everything will be all right.
If they believe me.
Well, they will. Hey, give us a smile, huh? Okay.
Well, I think that's it. I don't think I've forgotten anything.
It certainly doesn't look like it. You've got enough stuff there to equip an army. Queensland's the Sunshine State, you know. It's another world up there.
Well, I know I'm going to love it. It'll be wonderful to get away from here.
Well, if you're quite sure that you haven't left the gas on or the back door unlocked, we're just about ready to go.
No, everything's done. I've been round and checked to make sure. I've cancelled the paper and the milk. I don't think there's anything else.
Well, let's get started before you think of something.
A verdict is expected today in the case
just
of
a minute, Charles,
Travers,
I want to listen
who is
to
appealing
that.
Against a life sentence handed down in September of last year. Travers was convicted for the murder of her husband. And now for the sporting details. Football fans today are excited about the possibility of a fine win.
Why the sudden interest? Did you know her?
Yes, slightly. Long time ago.
I remember the original case. I always thought it was such a tragedy, a beautiful young girl like that, with the whole of her life ahead of her, and of course I only knew what I read in the papers at the time, but it always seemed to me there was much more to it than met the eye. I suppose the reason I felt sympathetic was because she was just about the age of my own daughter. Well, I wish her luck.
Vera does have a point, you know. I'd hate anything to go wrong.
I'm sure we can trust Lynn.
Those are my feelings too. Otherwise, I wouldn't have agreed. The press are particularly sensitive about outside work schemes at the moment.
Oh, that's only because of one or two isolated incidents.
That isolated incident is what sells newspapers.
Oh, don't they realize? I mean, it's far better to have a rehabilitated person taking a useful place in society rather than a prisoner who can only be a drain.
You don't have to convince me. You're talking to the converted. Some of the board already think that my ideas are far too liberal.
I'd like to extend the scheme to include other girls.
Yes, well, I don't want to rush into things. Let's see how Lynn gets on first.
She'll be fine, absolutely. No worries at all. I'll stake my job on her.
You already have. Mine too, possibly.
Hi, Mr. Butterfield. It's a lovely day, isn't it?
You reckon?
Mm-hmm.
Well, at least you're on time for your first day.
Oh, it's a good buzz. Bit of a hike up the lane, though.
Well, I must say, I wasn't expecting you to turn up all by yourself.
Oh, it'd be too embarrassing in a paddy wagon.
Yeah. Well, look, I better get you started. Let's see, you can put your stuff around here, see?
Mm-hmm.
And the toilet's around the back, okay?
Okay.
Now, you know about seedlings, don't you?
Oh, yeah, I used to do some transplanting with Dad, and we had this garden at the prison that,
Oh, good. Well, let's see what you can do with this lot. Now, I'll tell you what I want you to do. Mm-hmm. Take the seedlings out of the box and pot them in these, right?
Okay.
And then after that, label them all. Mm-hmm. Now, you'll find some gloves over there if you want to use them.
No, I'll be okay, thanks.
Oh, and put today's date on them, will you?
Yep.
Now, I've got to go out for a while,
mm-hmm.
but a Mrs. Grant will be coming in soon.
Yes.
She's usually only half an hour late. Any questions you can ask her?
Okay.
You'll be all right on your own?
Oh, yes, I've got plenty to do.
Okay.
See you, Mr. Butterfield. Come on, dogs. You coming inside?
Excuse me, madam. Would you be kind enough to come back to the shop with me and bring your handbag with you?
Come in.
Hi. Time for a break? I'm off to lunch. Want to keep me company?
Thanks, Jean. I'm a bit busy at the moment.
Oh. Well, that's okay. My ego can cope. Any news of Karen's trial?
Nope. Unless it's going better than it did yesterday, it'll be a farce. She won't stand a chance. I'm beginning to think it was all a stupid idea.
Why?
How's she going to take it if the jury goes against her, Jean? You're the expert, you tell me.
It won't be easy for her. But she can't be worse off than what she is now. Look, Steve Wilson is a very successful lawyer. Now, he wouldn't have taken on the case if he didn't think he could win.
Yeah, true.
Sure you don't want to come? We could go Dutch.
Oh, your offer touches me, but...
Well, good to see someone so dedicated to his work.
You got the order for Gregson's?
Oh, sorry, I don't know anything about it, but I'll get someone who does. Okay. Mrs. Grant! Look, I'm sorry, Mrs. Grant's not here and Mr. Butterfield's gone out somewhere.
No, it's okay, I found him.
Oh, are you sure? I wouldn't like to make a mistake.
Yeah, sure, look, there's the name.
Oh, fine.
Okay, how much do I owe you?
It'll be on the invoice.
$39.50.
Here you go.
Oh, you wouldn't have the right money, would you? The office is locked and I haven't got any change.
Look, I'm in a bit of a hurry. Buy yourself a Coke.
Stand on the white line. Shoplifting. On remand till tomorrow.
I'll handle it.
Could be difficult.
Oh, no name. One of those.
The usual refuses to give it. But the police have taken her fingerprints and checking the records.
Turn around. There's nothing to be gained by being uncooperative, you know. You can still be charged and convicted without a name on the warrant. In fact, there's an additional charge of hindering the police. Empty your pockets and put your bag here. One handkerchief. Cigarettes, matches. One purse containing $3.41. Compact. And a comb. That's all. Well, you're certainly traveling light. Give us your watch. We tell you what time it is in here. Sign. I said sign it! Well, if you're hoping your friends and family won't find out about this, you're wasting your time and ours. Thank you, Mrs. Jackson.
This way.
I'd have a good think in there if I were you. Troublemakers aren't welcome in here.
I would ask the jury to consider the emotional and mental state of Mrs. Travers after her abortion. That she is a devout Catholic has already been testified to by her parish priest, Father Byrne. I think that same afternoon, Mrs. Travers, after sacrificing the life of her child, came home to find her husband in bed with another woman. Now, this surely must bring forward the question, Your Honor, may I request a moment to have a word with my assistant?
Very well, but be brief, Mr. Wilson.
Mr. Wilson.
Your Honor.
Mr. Wilson, I hope this delay has some relevance to the proceedings.
Yes, it has, Your Honor, I assure you. Excuse me, Your Honor. And may I beg the court's indulgence? Some new evidence has just come to my attention, which I feel sure would influence the jury's decision. With the court's permission, I should like to call one more witness.
I object, Your Honor. This is most irregular.
I am well aware of that, Mr. Proudfoot. But if Mr. Wilson can assure the court that the introduction of a new witness is essential to his case, and that there be no delay, I'm inclined to agree. Do you give that assurance, Mr. Wilson?
I do, Your Honor.
Very well, then. Objection overruled.
Raise the Bible in your right hand. Repeat after me. I swear by Almighty God that the evidence I shall give in this case...
I swear by Almighty God that the evidence I shall give in this case...
...shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Shall be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth.
Replace the Bible. State your full name and address.
Mary Healy, 17 Banksia Street, Camberwell.
Mrs. Healy, could you tell the court, please, what is your relationship to the accused?
I'm her mother.
Now, Mrs. Healy, your daughter has testified that her husband was in the habit of beating her. Were you aware of this?
Yes.
Now, you'll have to speak up, please, Mrs. Healy.
Yes, on several occasions she came to me and showed me bruises she said he'd given her.
On several occasions. Could you tell us exactly how many?
Oh, I don't know exactly. Three or four. Certainly three.
What was your daughter's attitude toward having a family?
Oh, she was looking forward to it very much.
Your son-in-law, was he also looking forward to it?
No. He once said to me that if I wanted grandchildren, I'd have a long wait.
Did your daughter tell you when she became pregnant?
Yes, she did. I remember she was rather worried about what Wayne's, my son-in-law's reaction would be.
Did she tell you what that reaction was?
Objection!
Sustained. Really, Mr. Wilson, you know better than to introduce hearsay evidence.
Yes, I beg your lordship's pardon. Mrs. Healy, does the date September 14th, 1978 mean anything to you?
Yes, it does.
Would you tell the court, please, exactly what happened on that date?
Well, I remember I was feeling rather miserable, so I decided to pay Wayne and Karen a visit. I got to the front of the flat and... Well, before I could knock, I could hear Wayne shouting. They were obviously in the middle of a terrible row. I heard Wayne say that if Karen was pregnant, then she'd better get rid of it. He said he didn't want a snivelling brat ruining his life. I left without them knowing I'd been there.
Thank you, Mrs. Healy. That is all. No witness.
Mrs. Healy, would you say that you and your daughter were close?
I'd say we're as close as any grown-up daughter and her mother usually are.
And yet you didn't see fit to come forward at the original trial and give evidence?
Well, there didn't seem to be very much point. Karen had already admitted everything.
Tell me, Mrs. Healy, did you ever speak to your son-in-law about his so-called abuse of your daughter?
No, I didn't. I believed, God help me, I had no right to come between a husband and a wife.
Just one more question, Mrs. Healy. You have produced some evidence which, by your own admission, you felt wasn't important enough for the original trial. And yet now you expect us to find important enough to change the result of the original jury's findings. And what's more, not only do you quote this unimportant evidence verbatim, but you expect us to believe that you actually remember the exact date on which the alleged statements were made. Don't you think that's stretching the credulity of this court a little too far?
No, I don't. If you remember rightly, I said I was feeling rather down, and that's why I went to call on them. You see, September 14th is my birthday.
Thank you, Mrs. Healy.
No further questions.
Lynn's got a good day for it, hasn't she, Bea? Better than in here.
Oh, yeah, and if she's got any sense, she won't come back. Anything's better than this boring dump.
What are you talking about? You came back with your tail between your legs, didn't you?
Oh, fair go, Bea. When we went over the top, it was different.
Yeah, at least we had the guts to give it a go.
What are you trying to say, Doreen?
I'm not saying nothing.
Good.
Just the same, I wouldn't mind a day out now and then. Got to think of me heart, though. What do you reckon I put it to Mrs. Davison, eh, B? I've got nothing to lose.
Got nothing to lose? What a laugh. I can just see the governor saying to our Miss Vernon, I wonder if Mrs. Birdsworth would care to help out a couple of mornings a week in the canteen. A Carlton United Brewery.
Yeah, you'd think all your Christmases had come at once. That would be my dream job.
And what about you then? How'd you like a job floor walking at Mars?
Keep your hand in, eh?
Oh, yeah, think of all the things I could nick.
In your knickers, yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh, hi.
Well then, how are we going? All right?
Yes, fine, thanks, Mr. Butterfield. Are these okay?
Oh, just what I wanted. That's very good. By the way, what happened to the plants that were over there? Somebody call for them?
Yeah, he came and picked them up just after you went out.
Oh. Where's the money then, or didn't he pay for them?
Oh, I'm sorry, I just forgot, that's all. Yeah, I've got it here.
Trying to make a bit on the side, eh? Not bad, $40 on your first day out.
I just forgot, that's all, Mr. Butterfield. There's no need to call me a thief.
Now then, young lady, don't you get all high and mighty with me. Just remember it's your father I'm doing a favour for, right? You keep a civil tongue in your head.
Yeah, well, if I have to put up with cracks like that every day, I don't want any favours. Here, take your rotten life.
Dr. Miller speaking.
Oh, hello, Doctor. Stephen Wilson. I thought you might just like to know we're in with a chance. Karen's mother showed up at the last minute to testify.
She what? What made her change her mind?
Well, who knows? Maybe some of what I told her got through. The important thing is it's the break we've been looking for.
What difference will this make to the verdict?
Well, as one professional to another, I'd have to be cautious. Still, let optimism be the word for the day. The jury's out, so we won't have too long to wait. Are you still there?
Yes, of course.
Well?
Well, I'd almost given up hope.
Trust Wilson, Doctor. And keep everything crossed, huh?
Oh, I should have been here the first time.
I thought you'd be in Queensland by now.
Well, we were on our way.
Where's your fiancé?
Oh, he's outside in the car waiting, I hope. I told him everything.
What did he say?
He didn't say anything. He just turned the car around and drove back here. I think he was more upset that I almost walked out on you than about what you'd done. You see, he's got a daughter of his own about your age.
Will everything be all right?
Yes, I think so.
Well, let's just hope your efforts haven't been in vain. Lynn was not to go anywhere without your permission.
She just walked off.
For no reason. Mr. Butterfield, this could well cost her the chance of an early parole.
Yeah? Well, we did have a bit of a tiff about some money that was missing, but, I thought the girl might have been involved, but...
What?
She wasn't, Miss Vernon. It was all a mistake. See, what happened was this. A bloke called and he paid Lynn cash for the order. Mrs. Grant wasn't here to take the money and I was out too.
You mean you just left her here by herself? On her first day?
Well, she thought I was blaming her for taking the money. I suppose I was a bit rough on her. Look, Miss Vernon, I'm sure that's the reason she's walked off.
Well, Lynn was your responsibility, Mr. Butterfield. You should have reported it at once.
Well, I didn't know she was going to go off like this. I thought she'd have come back by now. Look, I don't want her to get into any trouble.
Have you got a telephone?
Yeah, over there.
Thanks. All right, Vera, just handle it that way. You know what's expected.
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
Yes? She's what? Have you notified the police? Why?
There's been a misunderstanding with the owner. Lynn's done nothing wrong, and he admits he's to blame. When she's had time to think, she'll turn up, I'm sure.
I hope you're right, Jean. We can't afford another scandal after the Frankie Doyle escape. Let me know as soon as anything happens. I want to be kept informed immediately. Lynn's disappeared.
Oh, I knew that girl shouldn't have been allowed out alone. Now do you believe me that Miss Vernon has no idea what she's doing?
Vera, we have to try. That's the whole point.
But Lynn Warner's a dangerous criminal. She's already been involved in one armed holdup.
I'm sure you have your own work to do.
Well, sorry, Miss Bennett.
What are you doing here? You're supposed to be in the laundry.
Oh, I'm not well. I feel real rotten. I keep getting these headaches. I think it's something to do with my claustrophonia.
What? What are you talking about?
Well, I keep getting these black spots behind me eyes and turning dizzy, and the screws... Oh, sorry, Miss Bennett. The officer said she thought I should see Dr. Miller. I reckon I'd feel better if I could get out in the fresh air like I did that day with Mrs. Davidson. I felt real good after
Birdsworth,
that.
Birdsworth, the only thing wrong with you is malingering.
Aye? God, what's that?
Oh, go on, you stupid woman, and then get back to work.
Oh. Gee, a bit of this wouldn't go astray. He could put his shoes under my bed any time.
Oh, what are you talking about? You wouldn't know what to do with it if you fell over it.
Oh, that's what you think.
Here, give us a look. Oh, gee, why don't they show all of him? Where'd you get it anyway?
One of the screws.
Yeah, might have known.
Lehman Quack. He says I need glasses. Says I'm getting the headaches because I need glasses.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing wrong with me eyes that a bit of fresh air and a change of scenery wouldn't fix, but he just laughed. Shouldn't have a framing license.
Yeah, well, I told you you're wasting your time, didn't I?
Yeah. Well, I don't know how long he's been practicing, but he'll never get it right at this rate.
Listen, if you were on the outside, Lizzie, you would have to get off your bum. No more sitting around with your feet up half the day, eh?
That's right, Smith. No sitting around with your feet up. The break was over 10 minutes ago. Let's see some work.
Hey, Vera. Who do you have to see to be recommended for that work release program? Not you, eh?
That's right, Smith. Not me, not Miss Vernon, not Mrs. Davidson, no one.
Oh. I knew no one would do me a favour.
Well, I wouldn't take it personally. It's not just you. There'll be no more work release for anyone.
Hey.
Lynn Warner's taken off.
Oh. On her first day.
But it's only just started. Oh, damn.
You're disgusting.
Oh, what would you know, prune face? GB, do you think what she said's true?
Oh, how should I know? Stupid little bitch.
Mr. Foreman and members of the jury, have you agreed upon your verdict?
We have.
How say you? Do you find the accused guilty or not guilty of murder?
Not guilty.
How say you? Do you find the accused guilty or not guilty of manslaughter?
Guilty.
Hearken to your verdict as the court records it. You find the accused guilty of manslaughter, and that is the verdict of you all?
It is.
Prisoner at the bar, you have been found guilty of manslaughter. Have you anything to say, or do you know why sentence of the court should not be passed upon you according to the law?
Well,
Well, Mr. Wilson, do you have anything to say at this time?
Your Honor, I would be derelict in my duty to my client if I were not at this stage to make a final plea for leniency. However, this court has already heard the tragic circumstances that brought Karen Travers here today. And we have dwelt at length on the emotional turmoil and mental trauma that she must have endured before taking that final action. Add to that the agony of having spent the past 6 months in prison with the prospect of many more years ahead of her, and you will have some idea of the punishment that this young woman has already suffered. And the jury has seen fit to reduce their verdict to the lesser one of guilty for manslaughter. And I feel quite confident that by leaving her to the mercy of this court, that I am leaving her incapable and understanding hands.
Very kind of you, Mr. Wilson.
The prisoner will rise.
Karen Travers, you have been found not guilty of murder, but guilty of the lesser charge of manslaughter. I agree with the verdict of the jury and commend them for their wisdom. On the question of leniency, I agree with Mr. Wilson that the court has heard sufficient to convince it that there were mitigating circumstances surrounding the killing of your husband, and that at the time of the killing, you behaved with impaired judgment. I therefore order that your sentence be reduced to 2 years, and you be given credit for any time you have spent already in custody.
All rise. This honorable court now stands adjourned until 10:30 o'clock tomorrow morning. God save the Queen.
Butterfield, any news? Oh, well, unless she's hitchhiking, she's not going to get back to the farm. She hasn't got any money. Listen, do you know if she's got any friends or relatives in Melbourne? Oh, yes, that's a good idea. I don't like to bother him, though. Yes, as soon as I can. Goodbye. Oh, can't it wait, Vera?
No, it can't. We have to call the police in now. It's standard procedure.
And that is Mrs. Davison's responsibility. What are you trying to do? Hang me, Lynn, and the governor on the one rope? So much for team effort.
This isn't a girl guide's camp. It's a prison and we're dealing with criminals.
Don't you think I know that? Anyway, she's not due back yet.
She is missing.
Sorry, ladies.
That's all right, Greg. Come in. Vera was just leaving.
Wilson phoned. Karen Travers has had her sentence reduced to 2 years manslaughter.
Great.
Listen, do you fancy dinner and a few drinks to celebrate?
Oh, Greg, I can't. I've just got so much happening. Look, I really do have a lot to do. Would you mind?
What was all that about?
What?
What's the matter with Jean?
Oh, Lynn Warner's run away from the nursery. Her ridiculous work release program has fallen apart on its first day.
No.
Oh, yes. Will they listen to me? I told them that a system that allowed convicted criminals loose on the street is going to be abused. And do you think they're going to do anything about it? If I was in charge here, the police would have known hours ago.
Mrs. Davidson certainly has her problems.
By the way, Mr. Warner, do you have any friends or relatives in Melbourne? Oh. No, it was just an idea. And I'll see you soon. Bye.
Hey, you look like the cat who swallowed the canary.
Oh, does it show?
Does it ever?
2 years. Oh, it's great news, Meg. I feel like celebrating. I asked Jean to come and join me, but she turned me down.
Oh, I think she's too worried about Lynn.
Yes, I know.
Well, why don't you come over to my place for dinner? Won't hurt Jean to have two of us on site.
Well, thanks. It's a deal.
Why don't you ask Steve Wilson? He might like to join us.
Oh, he's probably busy.
Oh, ring him and find out.
Yeah. Yes, all right, I will. What about 7:30?
Great. You like French food?
Oh, terrific.
I didn't know you could cook French food.
I can't. But it's one of the things that Jean does very well.
Oh, it's a pity she's so bad at her job.
Now, look here, Vera.
Meg, Mrs. Davidson wants to see you in her office.
It'll keep.
Chummy little lot, aren't they? You'd think they'd see enough of each other in this place. Well, I'm glad they didn't ask me. Come in.
Lynn?
No, the new prisoner. The one who refuses to give her name. The police have traced the fingerprints, and she has a record of previous convictions. They're sending over all the details. Mm. Would you bring her in? I want to talk to her. Yes. Oh, Jean, I was talking to the police about another matter. I had to tell them about Lynn. Sorry.
It's not quite 5 yet.
I know, but it should have been reported a long time ago.
Well, Miss Bennett, could you come out here for a moment, please?